Ghetto Heaven. Ghetto Heaven was kind of inspired. I have a friend named Gibbs, who I grew up with. In fact, he was the one that, because I used to, after I did that, because I did a sax solo, all the sax solos with Billy Ocean on his stuff, you know, Caribbean Queen, all of that stuff. Anyway, after the they didn't push the first album, I went to Van to get some advice, and he, you know, we had a meeting and we talked. And after the meeting in his house, we heard some music coming up from the basement. So we said, "Where's that music down here?" He said, "Oh, that's my son Salam. Salam Remy is famous producer. He produced Nas, Fugees, Grammy Award winning. He's very successful right now." So we went down and we heard the stuff that he was doing, and the stuff sounded so good. I saw Pete over in the corner bobbing his head. It's like he looked like he was chomping at the bit to get out. So after we left on the way back to Brooklyn, he said, "Let's go back to the crib." He said, "I got an idea." So we went up, put together some beats, and he just started fumbling on the piano and, you know, came up with an idea. So we just worked on Ghetto Heaven. That's where it started. Once the record company heard Ghetto Heaven, they said, "Okay, this is it." They knew it was a good song. So they said, "Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna send it over to Jazzie B." At the time, Jazzie B and Soul to Soul, they were really hot. So he remixed the song, he sent it back. I didn't really like it at first, but you know, I've learned to like it. Funny thing about it is, it coming out of London, people thought that we were from London. They thought we were part of like the whole, you know, soul to soul Jazzie B thing. I said, "Nah, we're from Brooklyn. We're from Brooklyn." So